1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. 12 reps, about a little over 2 minutes. And that's the warm up. So high intensity at its finest, ARX, the adaptive resistance exercise. Essentially, the motor just moves the platform at a constant speed, and you just try to push as hard as you can, eccentrically, concentrically, isometrically. Yeah, legs are feeling pretty pumped, knees feeling good, lungs are working hard. We'll hit one more set here, and then we'll get into the rest of the workout. Second set, a lot less time under tension, a lot less repetitions. Pretty much just went to concentric failure, so got to the point where I wasn't really pushing much on the way out, but still trying to resist as much as possible on the way back in. That's kind of the cool aspect of being able to use motor resistance as opposed to weights. With weights, obviously, there's nothing helping you. You can't really push that back out. Since the platform on this moves no matter what, whether I'm pushing it out or not, it's gonna go out. It's just not gonna speed up. So the intention is always just to push against the platform. Even when it's coming back, you're pushing into it to maximize the eccentric. Forces will go way up. And then concentrically, when you fail, it's like you have the perfect spotter the entire time. Kind of feels like a full leg workout, but just getting started. Slow, a little steady. Kind of shooting for like a 2 second pause, 3 to 5 second eccentric, and then kind of like a 2 second concentric. So I'm not pulling the weight down really aggressively, pulling my hips out of position, trying to just keep tension as much as possible here. And one kind of subtle thing is really locking this down to make sure that my knees aren't coming up and shortening the path that that hamstring has to go through. I want to try and think about like lengthening or keeping my foot as far away from my knee as much as possible. So as I'm pulling down, I'm kind of reaching my feet away to just keep the lever as long as possible in the hamstrings.
Good.
We will drop the weight down, do one higher volume set, and then hit some pendulums. Moving on to some banded pendulums. The band is just trying to match the strength curve, so it lets off a little bit at the bottom or the weakest, and then overloads a little bit at the top, so the tension just stays a little bit more consistent. But the tempo is the biggest game changer. All quads, a little bit of lungs, so win-win on the cut. Whew. Ouch. Nothing to say. Quads are burning. Knees feel really good though. Lungs. Last set here. Last set. Didn't think I was gonna make it up on that one. We'll get some hip presses in and some walking lunges maybe. Yeah, No, I said maybe. I'm trying to remember. Feel a little warm up. Nothing too crazy. Ouch. Tempo is a motherfucker. Okay. Let's go. Come on, get one more. Oh. Okay. Yeah. Leg extensions. Superset with some body weight walking lunges in between. That's what it was. At least it's body weight. Walking lunges, really just trying to help stretch the quads out. But I like to kind of just throw them in after this to really just facilitate a lot more knee durability. But after this, we'll be done with quads. One more set here, one more set with the walking lunges, hit some lying hamstrings, some adductors, and then post-workout meal. Oh. talk about this a lot. No need in a uncontrolled eccentric. No rapid eccentrics. Especially not for hamstrings, biceps, adductors. It's just not worth it. Okay, adductors, and then we're done. Finishing with adductors. Growing the adductors, obviously crucial for an overall kind of look for the legs, but being able to train adductors safely to failure is a little tricky. So getting as far as we can with just the concentric and eccentric tempo. And then as we can't do the concentric anymore, I'm just kind of helping on the way back in, just like a spotter would. And then just trying to control without any help for the eccentric portion until I can't do that anymore with control. But like I said, with the hamstring curls, not a movement that we want to rapidly go through an eccentric phase. It's very easy for these muscles to pull, strain, or even just kind of tighten up. And even just like a slight kind of tightening up of the adductor can start affecting all your other movements, squats, deadlifts, split squats, any of the compound stuff, just because they play such a crucial role in stabilizing the knee to hip relationship, the overall pelvic relationship, and your lower back stability too. So really something you wanna train, but train very methodically. Don't just come in and just start jamming your legs together. That is a wrap for today. Monday, we are on day 4 now of the cut. And so we'll get a maintenance or normal calorie day tomorrow. We're kind of on a low day for 4 days. And then every 5th day is a kind of like a maintenance calorie day. So it's not just cut nonstop. It's a little bit of high-low play, a little calorie cycling, just to refuel a little bit, but not go too crazy. So feel pretty good. Strength is still climbing up, even though we're cutting calories down. So I know it's gonna take a little while for our body to catch up, but can't really complain. Everything's feeling really good. Mentally, physically, so yeah, pretty fun, exciting stuff. But we will catch you tomorrow. We'll get a little posing practice after this, but we're gonna take a little break, get some post-workout fuel, and then come back later and cardio, pose, all that stuff. So we will see you tomorrow. Pull day, back, biceps. And yeah, Thanks for liking, watching, following, subscribing, loving, hating, all that stuff. Bo Alexander, Adapt Fitness, Dallas, Texas. Bye.